His foreign minister, everybody, did you know they said there was no pressure? He didn't do anything wrong. There was no pressure put on us. That didn't stop anybody.
Well, of course he said he wasn't pressured. The United States is a powerful nation on which his nation is dependent. He has a gun to his head.
Talking about the Ukrainian president there, that is the chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, as this is ongoing. We're heading towards a vote tonight there, and then eventually it'll head to the House floor. Let's bring in our panel, Washington Post columnist Mark Thiessen, Leslie Marshall, Democratic strategist, and Tom Bevin, Real Clear Politics co-founder and president. Okay, I want to start with this juxtaposition, Mark, of where we are. There's this impeachment that's going on, and it will happen. The votes, it appears, are there for Nancy Pelosi. At the same time, the president is getting probably his biggest bipartisan legislative win of his presidency, wins, and it could be his biggest legislative week to date. He's just seeing Boris Johnson get re-elected in Great Britain. The China deal's coming through, USMCA and the new NAFTA. And it's the same week, historically, it could be his worst week of being impeached as one of the few presidents who's being impeached.
Yeah. Well, first of all, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to strike the last word. Secondly, I actually think it's one of his best weeks, period. I mean, as you said, like, look, we started out on last Friday, 266,000 jobs created. Economy is booming. Boris Johnson, socialist defeated in Europe. USMCA, defense bill, which includes the, removed all the restrictions on wall funding. Space Force created. Paid family leave, pending spending bill that averts a government shutdown, and then on impeachment, the Democrats, after 3 years of telling, alleging that Trump had committed all sorts of crimes, extortion, campaign finance violations, bribery, obstruction of justice, conspiracy, treason, they've introduced two articles of impeachment that include no crimes, no statutory crimes whatsoever. First impeachment in American history that includes no statutory crimes. So the Democrats have effectively vindicated Donald Trump of any crimes. So, and on top of that, the polls on impeachment, when this started, there was a plurality of voters who supported the impeachment and removal. Today, majorities oppose his impeachment of removal. This is a home run week for Donald Trump.
Well, I want to get to the polls in just a second, but Leslie, Hakeem Jeffries, one of the really the guys who makes the case the best on the House Judiciary Committee for the Democrats, talking just a few minutes ago about the case.
We had more than 200 national security professionals, Democrats and Republicans, who expressed concern with the president's wrongdoing. This is a president that attacks everybody to distract, attacks everybody who won't bend the knee to Donald J. Trump. He even attacked today a 16-year-old teenage activist, Greta Thunberg. Are you here to defend that as well?
So they're all over the map. They're talking about the tweet there. So ridiculous. Greta must work on her anger management problem, then go to a good old-fashioned movie with a friend. Chill, Greta, chill. That's obviously the cover of Time magazine they're talking about there. Democrats, are they making this case as this continues nonstop for impeachment towards this vote?
I would say that they're not making any headway because we're seeing in the polls that people and their opinion is remain unchanged. I mean, if people don't like Donald Trump, or if they're a Democrat, if they believe that he did wrong and this is an impeachable offense, that's where they were, that's where they are. That's not, doesn't seem to change. The hearings haven't changed that. And the same can be said on the other side. Republicans or people that support the president or don't feel that this rises to the level of impeachment or don't want him impeached, they were there, they still are there now. And I don't think that's going to change. I also don't think it's going to change outcomes in the election. I think this is a very different time than it was during the Clinton impeachment. And I don't think that we're going to see Democrats hurt as bad as Republicans were then. And I do want to add that Greta added to her Twitter page that she is working on her rage issues.
And going to see a movie, I think she said. But you don't think that there's pressure on those 31 Democrats in Trump districts?
Yes, absolutely. 22 of them are freshmen. And we've already had one freshman in New Jersey who said, look, I'm out. You have two Democrats we know that from Missouri and from New Jersey are pretty much going to vote no because they voted no for the inquiry to begin with anyway. And a lot of others are keeping their
So you're over under is five or something?
Five to seven, they're saying maybe six. But she has the votes. Nancy Pelosi has the votes.
All right, since we have the RCP guy here, we'll put up your Real Clear Politics poll and the chart that shows the impeachment numbers and the impeachment removal from office. And you see the movement there as it's getting at its lowest level for the people who are for.
Yeah, it had been bumping along a slight plurality in favor of impeachment and removal. It was about 48, 45, 48, 46. It's now that gap is gone. It's dead even. Those are the national polls. And again, states are different.
And we've seen swing states be different.
Well, we just had a Marquette University law school poll come out today in Wisconsin showing that impeachment is 40 in favor of impeachment and removal, 52 against. That is no movement over the past 4 weeks. So no minds have been changed, and impeachment is underwater. Especially among independents in Wisconsin, also in Michigan, Pennsylvania.
Okay, panel, a little different show tonight. Thank you very much.